108. In earlier stanza, Mauna was defined as verily Brahma, which is beyond the realm of speech and the mind. The question may come, sir, that you are describing Mauna as Brahma itself, it is actually Dhyana. It is actually Dhyana, which is the 14th step. In this list, it is the 14th in number. You are talking it as the Mauna. How is it so? So therefore, alternate meaning is being given. So what is the alternate meaning? Okay. Brahma is such, yasmat vachaha nivartante, from which speech retires along with the mind without being able to objectify it. Last time we are seeing, speech has an excess only in those things which have got these attributes, jati, guna, kriya, and sambandha. Jati, a specific species. Guna, attributes, features. Kriya, action. Sambandha, relation. None of these exist in Atma. Why do they not exist? See, let us see now. Whether there is jati in Brahma or Atma. Which jati it will be? Brahmana Atma, Kshatriya Atma, Shudra, Vaishya Atma, Shudra Atma. No. Indian Atma, Pakistani Atma, American Brahma. Is it that way? No. It has no jati. Jati species comes when there are more members of a particular category having certain distinctions. Is it not? So Atma is what? Brahma is non-dual, so therefore no jati. Guna, attributes. Brahma is nirguna. When it is nirguna, free from characteristic features, etc. So therefore, guna also is not there. Kriya, action. You know, any action, do you know what it involves? Movement, chalanatmakam karma. Some movement, some change is required. Brahma is avikriya and therefore kriya is not possible. Sambandha, relationship. For relationship, minimum two are necessary. One getting related to the other. Brahma is advaya, non-dual, so relation also is not there. So that being the case, speech, in the sense words also, have no excess in Atma Brahma. You may ask, see, all Shruti speak of Brahma only, is it not? Yes, but they speak in the Lakshyartha, not Vachyartha, not in the direct sense of it, in the implied sense. So that is why Lakshana, Vritti, this, that, 100 things you have to do. So indirectly, because without that, how will you be able to communicate as such? So indirectly, in the implied sense that they speak of, that will describe what the Atma is. But in reality, it cannot be. So therefore, can you talk of Brahma, Atma? No. Why? Speech has no excess. See, this is all he is arriving at, that Mauna should be Sahaja. Natural. Why natural? You can't speak. Natural because you can't speak, therefore it is there. We'll see certain examples also. You say, okay, that is fine. Then, see, look, what has happened now? We can't speak about Brahma. Why? Brahma is not available for speech. Because jati, guna, kriya, sambandha is not. Then let us speak about the Jagat. I think we can do that, is it not? Can we do or not? Speak about the prapancha. He says that also is not possible. Do you know why it's not possible? Yadi prapanchaha vaktavyaha. If we have to speak about the prapancha, the world, he says, saha api shabda vivarjitaha. That prapancha jagat also is not available for the words to describe. This you have to little investigate. You may say, how do you say we can't speak about the world? All we speak about the what? World only. In what sense he has said that prapancha cannot be spoken of? In this instance case, I will give an example. Chandrasekhara Bharati, the grand guru of present Sringeri Shankaracharya. Once he was there in a room. The ashram, matha was there. One disciple inmate only. You are in fact today morning only, in some context I was telling this. So in morning, say a disciple was going and he entered the room. Entered the room, who is sitting? They call him Mahasannidhanam. Shankaracharya is saying, and he was lost in contemplation. He was always like that one. He was lost in contemplation. And when this disciple saw, he got a shock, because against the etiquette, without permission, just barging in the room where is, and he didn't know what to do. Chandrasekhar Bharati saw it, and seeing the plight is a mistake, etc. Just to consider, he signed him, sit down. Don't worry about that. He didn't speak, sit down. And he was lost in his own contemplation. After some time, he smiled. Who smiled? Chandrasekhar Bharati smiled. And again he was lost. And afterwards he asked that this inmate, do you know why did I smile? how he is to know why he smiled? Say, look, you have come. Etiquette demands that I should speak something to you. Because you have come, no? See, suppose a guest comes, at least how are you? I say, when did you come? At least etiquette, I should speak to you. Then I thought, what should I speak to you? Brahma, I can't. Why? Yato vacho nivartante. The speech is not, it cannot be described by the words. I can't speak the words. What is left out now? Prapancha. He said, this is the other way he has put. Prapancha, I need not talk also. Why? It is not worthy. I did not talk about the prapancha because it is not worthy of speaking. That's why I smiled. But here, it is given a little different way. You can't talk about Brahma, the prapancha also. You know what he means? Satchet na badheta, asatchet na pratiyeta. This prapancha is neither real, neither really existing, nor totally non-existent, and therefore it is something false, anirvachaniya in nature. Neither sat, because it is not sat. Prapancha is not sat. Why it is not sat? Because it is not trikala abadhita. It doesn't exist all the time. Why is it not asat, totally non-existent? We are experiencing movement by movement. So therefore, neither sat nor asat, and therefore it is what? Mithya in nature. Why? What mithya you can talk of? Which is really not existing. So therefore, there is nothing to be spoken about the jagat. Brahma, you can't speak also. What is the natural state now? Shut up the mouth. Chubbaito, nothing has to be done. So therefore say, yadi prapanchaha vaktavyaha saha api shabda vivarjitaha. It should be understood properly. How it is shabda vivarjitaha? Because it is neither sat, it is nor asat, anirvachaniya. You know, maya is said to be anirvachaniya, means inexplicable, which cannot be explained like this, this, this. So therefore, so that being the case, so either case, no talk is possible. Continuing, iti va here is not or, indeed, truly, iti va, maunam bhavet. Automatically, what is that? Maunam. You see, you have to keep quiet. Maunam bhavet. Tad satam sahaja saudnitam. It is a natural state of those who abide in the knowledge of oneself. Satam sahaja saudnitam is a natural state of the self. Now this is what mauna, according to whom? According to whom? We may say Shankaracharya, author, but actually it is Tejo Bindu Upanishad. This is from the Tejo Bindu Upanishad. These are just verbatim taken from Tejo Bindu Upanishad. Now the question comes, What is our concept of mauna? When you say mauna, keeping quiet. Sir, what are you telling us? See, ask anyone, mauna means, let's suppose somebody talks to him, are, chup baito. That is why don't talk. So that not talking is mauna. You are giving this meaning. Yes, yes, that also is there. That is there. Brahmavadibhi, Brahmajnanis has given that type of mauna, means not talking, as a means who are not that mature enough for the time being. You see it? Giram tu maunam. The mauna, keeping quiet, being silent as far as speaking is concerned. Gir means speech. As far as the silence of the speech is concerned, that is Brahmavadibhi Balanam Prayuktam. It is something recommended by Brahmavadibhi. Who are those Brahmavadibhi? Those who know what Brahma is, who have got Brahma Jnana. By them, it is something Prayukta, recommended for who? Balanam. Who are Balasna? Not children who has not that progressed much in terms of sadhana chatushtaya sampati, who are still at the beginning stage, they are mumukshus, still at the beginning stage of sadhanas. So for them it is said, because we know what happens, speaking is the one thing, it can sap away your energy, and you don't speak just like that. When you speak, what is there behind the speech? Mind is so much preoccupied in that, and therefore what happens? The speaking, that means it has to be curtailed. If you curtail the speech, mind also gets controlled to that extent. Even otherwise, keep aside as a sadhana, etc., excessive speaking is not good at all. This has become a curse nowadays among the student class. Speaking. Now cell phones are there also with them, etc. What they speak? Which serial is like what? Which film is like what? Etc. Yes, that's only the talk that is going on. And in the school, if you don't discuss, you are useless fellow. So that this too much of speaking, etc., you know what happens? Speaking has got a bearing on memory. It has got a bearing on excessive speaking means you lose the memory power. A glaring incidence is there. Swami Vivekananda was in that yatra, sir. So it happened that at one place, continuously for 10 days, he had to speak. There are no other alternative as well. And after that, he found that he is not able to remember anything at all. He was a little surprised. How is it? I am not able to speak. So he just consulted a senior monk, a Guru Bandhu only as well, a senior. This is what has happened to me. He asked, what are you doing last few days? So 10 days I had to talk. And said, do one thing. 10 more days, don't talk. Keep mauna. Don't talk. Of course, he had that much shraddha in him, a knowledgeable person, etc. He did memory regained. Satya Sai Baba repeatedly tells the students, don't talk other than whatever that is necessary. Because it has got a direct bearing on memory. And student means what? Memory must be sharp as well. Even keep aside your nididhyasana and all those things. There are too much of talking is not good. So for such people, some people say the other thing. They say they observe mauna once a week to make others' life miserable. At least that also has got some effect. Maybe they're at, you know what they do? Either by science they do something or they write. Narmada Bank one Mahatma Adar. I don't know whether presently is there or not. He has nearing 100 he was reaching. So he had this habit. Slate and then pencil goes on writing and showing, etc. It's not that. So few words you can, anyway, it has also some, depending on the individual, some place it has got as sadhana, that is fine as sadhana. So that is, therefore, this, giram to maunam, to show the contrast, the sahaja mauna, because why sahaja mauna? Brahma is not available for talking, nor Jagat is available for talking because anirvachaniya. So that being the case, natural state is not to talk of that. So this is, the other type of this is recommended by this Brahma Jnani as a preliminary sadhana for the persons who do not have staunch, that is sadhana chatushtaya sampatti. So now, the fifth step or the fifth samagri for nididhyasana, that is desha. So desha.
Agavante cha madhye cha.
Agavante cha madhye cha.
Jano yasminna vidyate.
Jano yasminna vidyate.
Yene dam satatam vyaptam.
Yene dam satatam vyaptam.
Sadesho vijana yutaha.
Sadesho vijana yutaha.
Anvaya. Yasmin. Adau ante cha madhye cha janaha na vidyate yena idam satatam vyaptam saha deshaha vijanaha srutaha. Again, yasmin adau ante cha madhye cha janaha na vidyate yena idam satatam vyaptam saha deshaha vijanaha srutaha.
So desha, generally for adhyatma sadhana, ekaki vijana means a place free from people is recommended. Ekaki yata chitta atma, Lord Krishna says, ekaki, solitary. Again, aratir jana samsadi means no, that means, that is inclination towards the good people, company of the people. Aratihi jana samsadi, no rati, no inclination, no desire to have the company of the people. Again, ekaki, solitary. So this is, generally this is necessary. Otherwise they say, see, second person makes the couple, third person makes the grama, fourth nagarayate. See, if one person is there, fine. Second person becomes a pair. Pair means goes on talking. Then third person means grama, means a bigger group. And fourth person means a big city, nagarayate. Then all talk starts, etc. Grama varta, raja varta, and in their sannyasis, bhiksha varta. Supposed to, hey, which kshetra you went for bhiksha? Such a, that kshetra is better. So there you get a better bhiksha. So like this, all these vartas, new start. Nowadays, don't ask at all. Newspaper, mass media, all this, you know what happens? Mind gets scattered. Mind gets scattered. Even if you see at any program for 5 minutes, you switch it off. Your mind is preoccupied, not five hours. It is preoccupied for the whole day as such, because that is the mind. Like, you know, see, on a lake with a calm and quiet surface is there, you just drop a pebble. It sinks, but how ripples go on coming? So like that, see that, such a mind is not immediately available for higher pursuit. So that means that's why generally vijana is advised. Now here, as per Tejo Bindu Upanishad or Shankaracharya says, he gives a novel vijana. What is that? You have to remain in the solitary place, is it not? You remain in such a place where jana, people, are not possible at any time. Generally, vijana means for the time being there are no people. Actually, vijana means it is not totally vijana, because you are jana or no jana. You as an individual, who is there? You make the jana, is it not? But still, ekake means other than you, nobody else is there. That is fine, sir. But you discover such a place where jana are not possible in the past, present and future. What is that? Where no people are possible to be there in the past, present and future. What is it? Brahma. See, with one or other excuse, all steps he brings to Brahma only. Means you get the different aspect of it. Different aspect. Say, so that is the best jana, the vijana place. What is it? Desha. What is it? Yasmin, that in which Adau, in the beginning, at the beginning of the creation, Ante, at the end of the creation, Madhe, in between the creation, what is that there? Janaha na vidyate. People are not there. What it can be? Brahma, which is free from creation. That alone, no other thing can be. Is it? You may say. So he says, no. There is a cave for thousands of years. Nobody was there. Then what happened? I discovered it. And I am using for meditation. That's fine. Adav was not there, but Madhya is there or Jana is there or not? No. So they're not that way as such. Not possible. Why? It can be Brahma only. And after, then what is it actually? We don't know what. This is the principle. What is that? Yena idam satatam vyaptam. That by which? Idam. Idam means this jagat is always pervaded. Means Brahma. It's only Brahma only. Vyaptam. Saha deshaha vijanaha smritaha. So therefore, that place is considered as free from people. Means you dwell in your swarupa free from people. So that, and if that capacity is there, even if you are in the market, you are vijana. And if that capacity is not there, even if you are in the remote cave, it is sajana only. Because all mind is preoccupied with other things. They need not be physically present as such. The mind is there, you are remembering, etc. Means it is sajana only. So this is the desha, the fifth one. Now, kala, the time. What is the time? See, generally they say in karma kanda, etc., you must have heard this. Tadeva lagnam sudinam tadaiva tara balam chandra balam tadaiva. Vidya balam daiva balam tadaiva lakshmi pate ste charanam smarami. O lakshmi pate te charanam smarami. I think of your feet. And that is the best time. They say, tadeva lagnam. Lagna means a Tadeva Lagnam. Lagna means an auspicious confluence of the planet, etc. Don't think Lagna means marriage. Not that marriage here. So it is the auspicious confluence. Tadeva Lagnam Sudinam Tadeva. That is the best day, auspicious days, you say, no? Akshay Tritiya, they say you did not see Muhurta at all. Whole day is auspicious, they say. That is it. Tadeva the Tara Balam Chandra Bada Balam Tadeva. That is the time when the stars are in a, that means, favorable position. Chandra Balam Tadeva. Even moon also is in a favorable position. Vidya Balam, strength of the knowledge. Daiva Balam, all deities are favorable. So what is that? Which is that time? Lakshmi Patehe Te Sharana Charanam Smarami. Te Lakshmi Patehe, of you, O Lord, Lakshmi Pati Narayana, your feet I am. This is generally the mantra you must have heard from the priest when they're puja. Tadaiva Lagnam Sudinam Tadaiva Tara Balam Chandra Balam Tadaiva Vidya Balam Daiva Balam Tadaiva Lakshmi Patesti Charanam Smarami. I have heard this many times when the pujas, etc. Tadaiva Lagnam Sudinam Tadaiva Tara Balam Chandra Balam Tadaiva Vidya Balam Daiva Balam Tadaiva Lakshmi Patesti Charanam Smarami. So now the question is, which is the kala, best time? So best time. So otherwise, no? Brahma Muhurta. All these are, look here, that doesn't mean that they have no relevance. All those have got the relevance. But the best time according to this is this. What is that? Let us see.
Kalana sarva bhutana.
Kalana sarva bhutana.
Brahma dinam nimeshataha.
Brahma dinam nimeshataha.
Kala shabdena nirdishtaha.
Kala shabdena nirdishtaha.
Yakandananda advayaha. Nimeshataha, at Arabhya, Brahmadinam, Sarva Bhutanam, Kalanat, Kala Shabdena, Akhandananda, Atvayaha, Nirdishtaha. Again, Nimeshataha and Arabhya Brahmadinam Sarva Bhutanam Kalanat Kala Shabdena Hi Akhandananda Advayaha Nirdishtaha.
Kalanat Kalaha. Kalana, actually, in the Tejo Bindu Upanishad original, Kalpanat is there. That becomes very easy. Kalpanat means because of projection. That which projects the entire creation, that is what is called as the Kala. But we are taking here Kalanat. Kalanat means because of assuming, because of possessing, or because of bearing, in the sense, Brahma, which assumes the form of the creation, which appears as the creation, that is what Kalanat. So that is what is called as Kala. Or also Kalanat can be that which withdraws unto itself. Brahma is the one which withdraws unto itself the entire creation at the time of Pralaya. Therefore also it is called as Kala. So therefore now let's see. And what is that which assumes or projects? Nimeshataha. Beginning from Nimesha. Nimesha is a moment, a kshana. Like we say second, etc. Akshana, just a moment. In terms of chronology, from a moment onwards, from akshana onwards, Brahmadinam Sarvabhutanam Kalanat, that which assumes itself as from movement to Brahmadi, etc. The trinities and all that, entire Sarva Bhutanam, entire Jagat, means that on which entire creation A to Z is superimposed. That which is the basis for the entire creation. So therefore, Kalanath, therefore it is called, so it is Kala Shabdena Nirdishtaha, indicated by Kala Shabda. What is it actually? Namely, says Kala Shabdena, he Akhandanandaha Advayaha Nirdishtaha. Nirdishtaha, what is indicated is Akhanda Ananda Swarupa Advaya Brahma itself is, that is what is indicated as the Kala. So therefore the way of that is booking means it is nothing but Brahma, which is the Kala. That is also true. See, yes, a auspicious time when we choose, what we will take into account? That which is Mangala, auspicious, is it not? Can there be greater auspiciousness than Brahma? Brahma tan mangalam param, supreme mangala. So that is there. So that its remembrance itself is the best time. Even Sripatehe te charanam smarami. So that is also is what? Because of the Parameshwara smarana itself is something which is holy. So that way, Brahma is the right time in the sense that is something most auspicious. So that is that. That being the key. Now which time will you choose now? Any time is the best time because it is, but no. Any time is the best time provided Brahma is in sight. Otherwise, not. Of course, look here. This is not for Vyavahara. In Vyavahara, marriage, etc., you have to find a Muhurta. You have to find. Suppose something, some auspicious thing that you have to find a Muhurta. We are not talking of Vyavaharya. This is Paramartha. So for Nididhyasana, any time is the most auspicious time. Still, because of the level of the sadhaka, we have to see like morning time, Brahma Muhurta, etc. They are, so that is what? They are more favorable. Means they are more conducive. Why conducive? Disturbance in the world is not there. You just get up at 4 o'clock and you don't need not meditate. You simply sit. Don't put on the channel TV. So don't put it on. You simply sit. See that atmosphere itself is such that don't put on the light also. Don't disturb others. Itself is something. And you see actually studies, etc., if you can take at that time, provided you are able to, it's something great. See, other studies which needs 2-3 hours, otherwise you can finish within a half an hour, yes, provided one thing. See, you should sleep early also. You should sleep early also. Otherwise, if you sleep late, then what? Your quota of sleep is not, your body needs some rest. That won't work as such. Nowadays in Bombay, even kids also are awake up to 11:30, 12 o'clock. Because there is no darkness at all. Everything is light. We remember as the school children, etc. 9 o'clock means midnight for us. I remember we never used to get dinner before 9. Do you know why? Once a dinner means sleep. Come on, study. Study. So until that you have to study as such. So not that way. So that is what. So I was saying that Bombay children never sleep. Even midnight they are just awake. Because the atmosphere is that. And now the TV, etc. on, you don't ask at all. As such. That's, no. See, this also is as even the students. They burn the night lamps. One more thing is that, especially for students, say, look, once you take the dinner, your capacity to study goes down. Simple. You see, this is a problem. Even the medical students also don't bother about this. Once you have eaten the food, what happens? Blood is required for the digestion. And you are studying, brain needs the blood. That's a tug of war between brain and the stomach. Who will win? Stomach will win, because it has got load of the food as such. So there is a simple common sense as such. So that's why best thing is to make a habit, sleep early and get up early. See, I used to go to Coimbatore ashram when our Pooja Swami used to out, just for one text or so I used to teach and come, etc. So they had that system, the morning class at 8 a.m. and before that breakfast is over. So whenever I speak, I said, look here, you do whatever you want, keep my time before the breakfast. I don't want to take the class after the breakfast. They had to change it when I used to go, etc. Brahmacharya school, etc. So that is first breakfast. This is American system. It started because of that only. Because I mean, America ashram, that cold, no, very cold country, you have to take the breakfast first, and because otherwise it is too early to start the class, that is that. I said, with something in the stomach, neither I want to speak nor I want them to listen. I want them to listen also, so you change the breakfast time. They used to change it. That is the rest. So that is 7 to 8 and then 8 o'clock breakfast. So like that. So it has got, because food needs the blood for circulation. Brain needs the blood for, that is, study, etc. So that is how it is. So that is fine as such. But from here, any time is an auspicious time, provided your mind is centered where? On Brahma. Therefore, that Akhandananda Advaya is indicated by the word Kala. That is the best time. Now asanam, which asana you have to take to, for what? Nididhyasana. I think Vajrasana is the best asana, is it that way? Let us see now. So it is.
Sukhe naiva bhavet yasmin.
Sukhe naiva bhavet yasmin.
Ajastram brahma chintanam. Asanam tad vijaniya.
Asanam tad vijaniya.
Itarat sukhanasanam.
Itarat sukhanasanam.
Anvaya. Yasmin. Ajastram. Brahma chintanam. Sukhena. Eva. भवेत् तद् आसनं विजानीयात् इतरत् न सुखनाशनम् अगेन् यस्मिन् अजस्त्रं ब्रह्मचिन्तनं सुखेन एव भवेत् तत् आसनं विजानीयात्
Another point, of course it has nothing to do with that, because the topic of study and dinner came from that standpoint, but nothing to do with Adhyatma. See, nowadays the lifestyle has changed in such a way, by the time the person returns home after from office or business, profession, etc., it is 8, 9, 10, etc., and then dinner, late dinners. Now what happened? Farther the time from the sunset of this thing, dinner, it is not desirable. It should be near the sun, because that digestive capacities, they go on, that means dwindling as such. That is that. And if such a thing is that, And if it is a custom, that is a habit, a late dinner, etc. Those dinners you don't, club, etc., don't ask at all. Even at home also, that is there. So what happens? Then all cholesterol, this, that are bound to come. And once a tired person, khana khaya, baad mein, so gaya. So gaya. It has got a bearing on the, this thing. So I heard an interview of a specialist, a doctor only from USA, Indian only, but he has specialized in this area. It was an interview on the radio side. And he was interviewed by Professor Venkatraman. Venkatraman, he was a retired director of IIT and also director of DRDL and then finally Vice Chancellor, retired Vice Chancellor of Puttaparthi University. So some topic came about that how that America children are becoming fat and it is now started coming to India and all this. So then topic came that the dinner, that American doctor, American, Indian only, that doctor was telling, see, we finish the dinner by 5:30 p.m. He said, our bhajans don't get over by 5:30 p.m. in the prashanti nilaya. That is fine, but at least up to 7:30, but it's not possible, lifetime. Your profession is there, your office is there, your traveling is there, etc. So that is how it is. Anyway, that is the price we have to pay for modern way of life, yes. That it is. But we should be aware of it. We should be aware of it. So now, what is the asana posture? Which is the say, yasmin ajasram brahma chintanam sukhena bhavet. Yasmin, in which state? Your state stands for mano avastha, manasaha avastha, disposition. That in which disposition, the state of the mind, or it can be, yasmin also can mean, one meaning is, manovasthayam, yasmin manovasthayam, or in which disposition, that is one meaning. Other meaning can be, yasmin can be yena prakarena, by which mode, yasmin, what happens? Ajasram brahma chintanam sukhena eva bhavi. What takes place? Brahma chintanam, the contemplation on Brahma. How? Ajasram. Ajasram means continuously, constantly. Continuously and constantly. And how? Sukhena bhave. Sukhena means anayasena, without much effort, easily. Easily, bhavet takes place. Tad asanam vijaniya. That should be taken as the asana. And not na itarat sukhanashanam. Not other asana, which is not asana, sukhanashana. You sit in vajrasana. Have you seen? You say vajrasana is the best, is it? You know, both one over the other. And you see that where that bones meet, crucial pain, such a pain that comes, etc. Something like that. Sukhanashanam, it will remove your poise of the mind. Not that. Asana needs practice. It needs practice. So that is that. No? Asukhanashanam. You know that Buddha had so many disciples. And after Nirvana of Buddha, all the disciples decided they will have a conference and put on paper what is the teaching of the master. But one qualification was there. Whichever disciple who attends the conference must have Nirvana, according to them. Nirvana. So all stalwarts. There was a disciple, Ananda. by name Ananda. And this Ananda was the one who was personally attending Buddha. Means he used to take care of his personal needs, and therefore he had always the physical proximity of Buddha. So therefore he is the best participant, but qualification wise he was disqualified because he had no nirvana. Accordingly, he had no nirvana. So the other Guru Bandhu said, Ananda, your presence is required. You are the most VIP here, very important person. Why don't you get nirvana and get qualified and attend the conference? Because your contribution will be something invaluable. Because you have heard our master in and out, and therefore Ananda also thought, yes, it is there, and he started putting forth the efforts for getting nirvana. Nirvana nahi hai, nibbana bhi nahi hai, kidhar, nowhere near. But he was struggling hard at that. Now the date of conference is nearing. Nowhere nirvana. So nowhere nirvana. Again, now last but one day, no nirvana. Tomorrow is the conference. So night also he practiced. Jesus, they did a lot of practice, etc. No, midnight over, no, 1 o'clock, no nirvana, 2 o'clock, no nirvana, 3:30, no nirvana. Ananda said, let it go now, I give up, not that. And he was reclining, and he had not laid down, reclining, they said he got nirvana. And they say, Ananda got nirvana in 65th asana. according to Yoga Shastra, 64 asanas are there. And his asana was that, no, at least he was lying down, shavasana. That also was not, neither he was sitting. He was about to recline as such. And in that posture, they said he got the asana. So they say, Ananda's asana is 65th asana. Now, this asana is 66th asana. So, this is 66th asana. What is it? So that wherein easily the mind can get absorbed in the Brahma Swarupa. That is the asana. And other physical postures is Sukhana. That doesn't mean that you say you should stop squatting, etc. it is necessary. So that is the answer. And now the context of asana has come. In that they say siddhasana is an easy asana and a good asana. So that he just by the by he takes siddhasana. What is the best siddhasana? It's all this only nididhyasana only. From that standpoint, according to that, this also Tejo Bindu Upanishad also. So that by, so in the context has come of asana, a specific asana called siddhasana, according this is being told.
Siddham yat sarva bhutadi.
Siddham yat sarva bhutadi.
Vishwadishthanam avyayam.
Yasmin
siddha samavishtaha.
Yasmin siddha samavishtaha.
Tadvai siddhasanam viduhu.
Tadvai siddhasanam viduhu.
Anvaya. Yat. Sarva bhutadi. Siddham. Vishwadishthanam. Avyayam. Yasmin siddhaha samavishtaha tatvai siddhasanam viduhu. Again, yat sarva bhutadi siddham vishwadishthanam avyayam यस्मिन् सिद्धाः समाविष्टाः तद्वै सिद्धासनं विदुः.
यत् वट् एवर् और् देट् विच् सर्वभूतादिसिद्धं. सिद्धं मीन्स् अकम्प्लिश्ड् और् ईस् वट् एवर् देट् ईस् द आदि द बेसिस् आफ् आल् द बीङ्ग् मीन्स् एण्टायर् क्रियेशन्. वट् इस् द बेसिस् आफ् एण्टायर् क्रियेशन्? ब्रह्म. सर्वभूति. देट्स् वै सेत् वट् इस् देट् सिद्धं विश्वाधिष्ठानम् अव्ययम् अधिष्ठान द बेसिस् आफ् एण्टायर् विश्व इट् सेल्फ् इस् अव्यय. अव्यय मीन्स् इन्डिस्ट्रक्टिबल् ब्रह्म ओन्लि. देट् इस् वाट् इस् देट् इस् द सिद्धासनम्. आर् इट् केन् बि ऐदर् वे इट् मीन्स् वन् एण्ड् द सेम् ब्रह्म ओन्लि. अदर् वे इस् आर् अथवा यस्मिन् सिद्धाः समाविष्टाः that in which siddhas. Now this siddhas, don't take pauranika siddhas here. Your siddhas mean brahma jnanis, those who have got the brahma jnana, those who have accomplished the brahma jnana. Yes, mean siddhah samavishtah. Samavishtah means sit in the sense occupy, enter also. Samavishtah means enter. Brahma Jnana is enter where, occupy where? In Brahma. Those are abiding in the Brahma. So therefore, Samavishta Tadvai Siddhasanam Viduhu. That is said to be the Siddhasana. The one which is the very basis of entire creation, that way Siddham, accomplished one, Brahma only. Otherwise, that wherein the jnanis always abide, that also is Brahma, that is the Siddhasanam, that can be taken as the Siddhasanam. Now we'll see what is the bandha, the mula bandha, etc. We'll see that.
Om Swasti Prajapati.